Hello friends, welcome to TalentSprint. I hope all of you are preparing well for your upcoming exams. So today we are going to discuss the third week of December current affairs, and for today's session we have around 45 to 50 questions. So I'll represent all the questions one by one. So here is the first question on your screen. On which day the International Migrants Day is organized across the world to protect the rights of migrant workers and members of their families? And the answer here is, it's 18th of December. So it is celebrated to protect the rights of migrant workers and members of their family. And the theme for this year was We Together. Now the next question. Dash, a veteran actor who played an important role in the growth of theater movement in Maharashtra, passed away recently. And the answer here is, it's Sriram Lagu. And if you look at the other option, here the second option is given L.S. Sesagiri Rao. He's a Kannada writer and critic who passed away recently. And the third option is given Thomas Chandy. He was the former Kerala minister who passed away recently. Now the next option is given I.D. Swami. He's the former Union Minister of State for Home Affairs in 1999 who passed away recently. And the last option is given Siddharth Kak, who is a Bollywood actress who passed away. Now the next question. A national program Dash launched a government e-commerce portal, that is GM, to bring on board more local sellers. And the answer here is, it's GM Sambad. So the government e-commerce portal, that is GM, will take place with the stakeholders across the country and with the local sellers to facilitate onboarding of local sellers on the marketplace. And GM has more than 15 lakhs product and around 20,000 services and more than 3 lakhs registered sellers and service providers. And who is the Commerce Secretary of India? It's Anoop Wadhwan. Anoop Wadhwan. Now the next question. A popular classical music festival, Tansen Samaroh, is celebrated every year in the memory of most eminent singers of Indian history, Mian Tansen, and this festival celebration has started in Das, and it has started in Gwalior, right? And this is the 95th year of this festival. And who is the Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh? It's Kamal Nath. Governor is Lalji Tandon. Now the next question. Which state police has become the 7th state police to be honored with the President's Scholars? And the answer here is, it's Gujarat. And the President's Scholars is also known as Nishan, which is an emblem that will be worn by all the police officers on the left-hand sleeves of their uniform. And this is previously awarded to the states of Uttar Pradesh, Delhi, Jammu Kashmir, Tripura and Assam. And who is the Chief Minister of Gujarat? Vijay Rupani, and Governor is Acharya Devavrat. Now the next question. Who has been awarded with BBC Sports Personality of the Year 2019? And the answer here is, this has been awarded to Ben Stokes. And he belongs to which team? He belongs to England. Now the next question. To encourage the orange producers and to promote the orange fruit, the Orange Festival was organized in Das. And the answer here is, it is organized in Manipur. And who is the Chief Minister of Manipur? N. Biren Singh, and Governor is Najma Hepatullah. Now the next question. The Government of India and the Asian Development Bank has signed a Dash loan for energy efficiency investment in India. And the answer here is, it's $250 million. And this loan aims to expand the energy efficiency investment in India that will benefit the agricultural, residential and industrial consumers. And additionally, another $46 million financing will be provided from the Clean Technology Fund, that is CTF. CTF is going to provide another $46 million. And the project is expected to contribute the mission of the Government of India to promote the energy efficiency and to meet the government's commitment to reduce the energy intensity of the economy. Now the next question, who among the following has been appointed as the chairman cum managing director of National Aluminium Company Limited? And the answer here is, it's Sudhir Patra. So Nalco is a Navratna company and it is founded in the year 1981. Where is the headquarter? Headquarter is located in Bhubaneswar of Orissa. Now the next question here, the Reserve Bank of India has waived off NEFT and RTGS transfer charges for DAS account holders. And the answer here is, it has been waived off for saving account holders. So who is the governor of RBI? Shaktikant Das. And where is the headquarter? It is in Mumbai and it was founded in the year 1935. Now the next question. The State Bank of India has signed a loan agreement worth of DAS with the KFW, that is German Development Bank, for establishing an energy efficient housing program in India. And the answer here is, it's $277 million. And it is around 1,958 crore. And who is the chairperson of SBI? Rajnish Kumar. Where is the headquarter located? It is in Mumbai and it was founded in the year 1955. Now the next question, DAS, the anti-hijacking exercise recently conducted by the Indian Navy, Indian Coast Guard and Cochin Port Trust and all other concerned stakeholders of the port of Kochi. And the answer here is, it is named as Apaharan. So this Indian Coast Guard was founded in the year 1978. And headquarters is located in New Delhi. Now the next question, which private sector bank has become the third Indian firm to cross $1 billion mark in market capitalization? And the answer here is, it's HDFC Bank. So among the world's most valued banks and financial companies which have a market cap of over $100 billion, the HDFC Bank is ranked 26th position. Who is the managing director of HDFC? It's Aditya Puri. Where is the headquarter? It is located in Mumbai of Maharashtra. Now the next question, the goods and service tax or GST Council has fixed a uniform tax rate of DAS on both state-run and private lottery. And the answer here is, it's 28%. And this GST charges has been implemented in the country since 1st July of 2017. Now the next question, how much concession will be Indian Railways offer to the youth participating in the Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat program? And the answer here is, it's 50%. Who is our railway minister? It's Piyush Goyal. And this concession will be given in the base fare of second and sleepers class to the youth with an emolument of not more than 5,000 rupees per month for traveling from one state to other state to take part in this program. Now the next question, India and DAS have signed an agreement to facilitate the transfer of defense technology during 2+2 dialogue held in Washington of DC. And the answer here is, it's USA. Who is the Ministry of Defense? It's Rajnath Singh. And who is the Ministry of External Affairs? It's Subramaniam Jaishankar. Now the next question, Social Justice and Empowerment Minister has launched the Braille version of the book Das, written by the Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And the answer here is, it's exam warriors. So the Braille version in English and Hindi has been printed by the Rajasthan Netrahim Kalyan Sangh in Jaipur. And who is the Social Justice and Empowerment Minister is Thawar Chand Gehlot. And here is the next question. Who among the following has been appointed as the Managing Director of the General Insurance Corporation of India? And the answer here is Devesh Srivastav. When this founded, GIC, that is General Insurance Corporation of India, this was founded in the year 1972 and headquarters is in Mumbai. Now the next question here, the Asian Development Bank and the Government of India has signed a dashed loan to upgrade the roads of Madhya Pradesh. And the answer here is, it's $250 million. And the loan is signed for the public-private partnership project through the hybrid annuity model to upgrade about 1600 km of state highways and major district roads in the state of Madhya Pradesh. So where is the headquarter of Asian Development Bank? It is in Manila of Philippines. And who is the president? It's Takehiko Nakao. So here is the next question. The Indian Pharmacopoeia has been recognized formally by which countries? National Department of Regulation of Medicines and Health Products of the Ministry of Public Health. And the answer here is, this has been recognized by Afghanistan. So Afghanistan become the first country to recognize Indian Pharmacopoeia. And Indian Pharmacopoeia is an officially recognized book of standards as per the Drugs and Cosmetic Acts 1940 and Rules 1945. And it specifies the standards of drugs manufactured and marked in India in terms of their identity, purity and strength. Now the next question, which country Prime Minister announced the setting up of a Gandhi Citizenship Education Prize? And the answer here is, it's Portugal. So Portuguese Prime Minister Antonio Costa announced it, and the first edition of this prize will be dedicated to the animal welfare, because Mahatma Gandhi said that the greatness of a nation can be judged by the way its animals are treated. Now the next question, the International Human Solidarity Day is organized across the world on DAS, and it is celebrated across the world on 20th of December. And this is celebrated to raise the public awareness of the importance of solidarity and to remind the government to respect their commitments to the international agreements and to encourage the new initiative for poverty eradication. Now the next question. DAS has won the Sahitya Academy Award in non-fiction category of An Era of Darkness, and it is written in English language. And the answer here is, it's Shashi Tharoor. So Shashi Tharoor has been awarded with the Sahitya Academy for An Era of Darkness, that is written in English language. And if you look at the other option, the second option is given Nandakishore Acharya, and he has been awarded with the Sahitya Academy Award in poetry category for Chillate Hue Apne Ko in Hindi language. And the third option is given Penna Madhusudan, and he has won the Sahitya Academy Award in poetry category again for the poem written in Sanskrit language. And the next option is given Safiq Kidwai, and he has been awarded for the Urdu biography. And the last option is given Joyce Goswami Mahant, and she has been awarded for the Chanakya novel that is written in Assamese language. Now the next question, who has been appointed as the Lokayukta of Telangana? And the answer here is, it's C.V. Ramulu. So he is the former High Court Judge, Justice C.V. Ramulu, who has been appointed as the Lokayukta of Telangana. And apart from him, if you look at the other option, it's given V. Niranjan Rao. He has been appointed as Upa Lokayukta. Upalokayukta. And G. Chandraya, he has been appointed as the chairman of the State Human Rights Commission. Now the next question. Who among the following Indian weightlifter won the women's 49 kg category gold medal at the 6th Qatar International Cup held in Doha? And the answer here is, it's Mirabai Chanu. So what's the capital of Qatar? It's Doha, and currency is Qatari riyal. Now the next question. Which of the following African country recently launched its first satellite at the space station in China? And the answer here is, it's Ethiopia. And with this, Ethiopia became the 11th African country to put a satellite into the space, and Egypt was the first in 1998. So what's the capital of Ethiopia? It's Addis Ababa. And currency is birr. Now the next question, which country has been crowned FIFA Team of the Year for the second successive time? And the answer here is, it's Belgium. And who is the president of FIFA? It's Gianni Infantino, and it was founded in the year 1904, and headquarters is located in Zurich. Now the next question. Google searches for DAS surged in India after the central bank announced its version of the US Federal Reserve's unconventional monetary policy. And the answer here is, it's Operation Twist. Now the next question. Which of the following international organization recently extended its partnership with the International Cricket Council for Women's T20 World Cup 2020 with a focus on empowering women and girls through cricket? And the answer here is, it's UNICEF. So who is the CEO of ICC, that is International Cricket Council? It's Manu Sahani. And who is the ICC chairman? Shashank Manohar Parikh. Now the next question here. So who is the chairman? It's Shashank Manohar. And where is the headquarter located? It is in Dubai. Now the next question. Who among the following Indian-American computer scientist will lead the prestigious National Science Foundation in the USA? And the answer here is, it's Sethuraman Panchanathan. Now the next question, which day was observed every year as the National Mathematics Day? And the answer here is, it is on 22nd of December. And this is observed on behalf of the birth anniversary of the mathematician Srinivasan Ramanujan. And this is the 132nd birth anniversary of Srinivasan Ramanujan. Now the next question here. Who has been appointed as the Prime Minister of Cuba after 40 years? And the answer here is, it's Manuel Marrero Cruz. And who is the President of Cuba? It's Miguel Díaz-Canel. He is the President. What is the capital of Cuba? It's Havana. And currency is Cuban peso. Now the next question. How many West African countries have agreed to change the name of their common currency to ECO? And the answer here is, it's 8 countries. Now the next question. Who among the following has been appointed as the first woman chief technology officer at the US government's powerful Federal Communication Commission? And the answer here is, it's Monisha Ghosh. So she will be taking charge on 13th of January, replacing Eric Berger. Now the next question here, in which country Government of India has constructed girls hostel for armed police force school? And the answer here is, it is in Nepal. So who is the Prime Minister of Nepal? It's KP Sharma Oli. Capital is Kathmandu. And who is the President? It's Vidya Devi Bhandari. Now the next question. Which state government laid the foundation stone of two integrated organic food processing units of IFFCO Organic Limited? And the answer here is, the foundation has done in Sikkim. Now the next question, in which country the 19th Joint Commission meeting will be held? And the answer here is, it is going to be held in Iran. Now the next question, in which city the national program called Eco Network was launched? And it was launched in New Delhi. Next question, who honored with the Silver Jubilee International Conference of Art in Dhaka by Bangladesh? And the answer is, it's R. Nagaswamy. So he is an archaeologist who honored with the Silver Jubilee International Conference of Art in Bangladesh. He is an Indian historian, archaeologist and epigraphist. Now the next question. Aditya K, honored with the Bharat Award for bravery, belongs to which state of India? And he belongs to Kerala. Who is the Chief Minister of Kerala? It's P. Vijayan. Governor is Arif Mohammed Khan. And where is the capital? It is in Thiruvananthapuram. Now the next question. Who has released the book Turbulence and Trump, The Modi Years? And which is written by the Rahul Agarwal and Bharti S. Pradhan? And the answer here is, this has been released by the Vice President Venkaiah Naidu. Now the next question. Who among the following were named for the International Tennis Federation World Champions in Women's Singles for 2019? And the answer here is Asleh Bharti. Now the next question. Who among the following were named for the International Tennis Federation's World Champions in Men's Single for 2019? And this has been given to Rafael Nadal. So with these two awards has been given to Asleh Bharti and Rafael Nadal, were named as the International Tennis Federation World Championship in Singles for 2019. And where is the headquarter of this International Tennis Federation? It is in London. And who is the president of ITF, that is International Tennis Federation? It's David Haggerty. He is the president of ITF. And with this question, we have come to the end of this session. We covered all the important bits from the third week of December. And I would like to suggest, if time permits, just try to explore the other sources for current affairs, right? Because it plays a very big role in cracking these competitive exams and especially bank exams, right? And we'll meet next year with the fourth week of December current affairs and monthly current affairs. Till then, keep reading, stay tuned. Thank you.